You know those which will cause a cell to shrink or swell questions with answer choices that all sound the same and can trip you up, like this one? These concepts seem so easy when you were learning them in class, but then you keep getting them wrong on tests? I'll show you why and how to get them right every time. First, know that it's water that causes cells to shrink or swell, not solutes, meaning only water can change the volume of a cell, not the tiny solute particles moving in or out of the cell. When too much water flows in, the cell swells. When too much water flows out, the cell shrinks. Also know that water moves in or out of a cell based on solute concentration. If the cell is hypertonic, meaning has a higher solute concentration than the surrounding solution, water will flow into the cell to dilute the cell cytosol until isotonicity is reached between the cell and surrounding fluid, meaning until there's an equal concentration inside and outside the cell. If the cell is hypotonic, meaning has a lower solute concentration than the surrounding solution, water will flow out of the cell to dilute the surrounding solution until isotonicity is reached. Now, this is the most important thing to know to help get these questions correct every time. When solutes can permeate the cell membrane, solute will move down its concentration gradient from high to low concentration and equilibrate itself, meaning reach isotonicity itself, creating an equal concentration inside and outside the cell without water having to move in or out, and thus without the cell swelling or shrinking. But when solutes cannot permeate the cell membrane, solute can't equilibrate itself. So water will have to move toward high solute concentration to help the cell reach isotonicity, and water movement will cause cell swelling or shrinking, depending on whether the cell is hypertonic or hypotonic, respectively. In this case, since the cell was hypertonic, the cell will swell and maybe even burst. Now back to the question with our trusty beaker on the side. It's asking which answer choice would cause the cell to shrink. It says sucrose cannot permeate red blood cell membranes, but glucose can. So if glucose can permeate the cell membrane, then in a hypoosmotic glucose solution, lower glucose concentration in the surrounding solution, glucose will just move from inside the cell to the surrounding solution until the cell is isotonic, without water having to move in or out, and thus no shrinking or swelling of the cell, which eliminates C. And a similar effect would be true for a hyperosmotic glucose solution, so we can also eliminate A. And now we don't even have to consider glucose when choosing between B and D. Now, between B and D, the hypoosmotic sucrose solution in answer choice D came up previously. That's when we had a hypertonic cell, higher sucrose concentration inside the cell and low outside, making it a hypoosmotic solution. In this case, water flows into the cell toward higher sucrose concentration for the sake of reaching isotonicity, causing the cell to swell, not shrink, so eliminate D, which leaves us with B as the correct answer. But let's recap why this solution causes the cell to shrink. This is when we had a hypotonic cell, lower sucrose concentration inside the cell than outside, making it a hyperosmotic solution. In this case, water flows out of the cell toward higher sucrose concentration in the surrounding solution, resulting in the cell losing water for the sake of reaching isotonicity and shrinking, which confirms B is the correct answer. Simple as that.